Hello, this is Mark from Productive Computing. Thanks for joining us on this video. If you are working with the Claris FileMaker platform and you find yourself a developer looking to make QR codes, then you've come to the right place. This video will make this really simple for you. I'll show you a file that I created just this morning, in fact, to talk to a free API to send it a URL. And what you'll get back is a QR code in a container field, ready to go, ready to print, ready to export, ready to do whatever you'd like to do. So first, before we get too much further ahead of ourselves here, I wanted to take a few moments to talk about the history, because I think it's important to kind of see what this technology is. Why is the world now using QR codes? What's wrong with the old barcode? I mean, we still use barcodes at the supermarket, right? Well, that's essentially true, but the QR code has some really big distinct advantages, and I thought it would be interesting to explore that. So first of all, the QR code stands for Quick Response Code, and it was created all the way back in 1994. And although 1994 seems like eons ago, technically the QR code is the new kid on the block relative to all the other barcodes. And it was created by a Japanese automotive company called Denso Wave, and they needed a way to have a machine-readable optical label that could contain information about the item to which it's attached. That's fancy words for saying they needed a lot of information in a small footprint and the size of a label. And they needed to be able to scan that and have all that information be translated to whatever their reader is or whatever their database was to look things up. So the QR code came to the rescue. It's also known as a two-dimensional barcode. And I think that's a very fitting name for it because it is stuffing a ton of information into just a tiny little space. And it's two-dimensional because it doesn't just read left to right. It reads sort of up, down, left, and right all at the same time. And these boxes and symbols are meaningful to a computer. We don't spend a lot of time looking at the details of a QR code, but it is quite fascinating. And you can almost tell how much data it contains by the density of it and by how many black lines there are all over the place. And these codes can contain thousands of characters, whereas a traditional barcode we think of as maybe 30 to 100 characters. These can contain thousands, and that's what makes them special. But that's not the only thing that makes them special. The other thing that makes them special is that they are extremely fault tolerant. And when you create these QR codes, you can set out to determine how fault tolerant they are and how much data you can live without for them to still be able to work. Here's an example of a damaged QR code that still works with a reader. Now, based on that same concept, you can actually brand your QR codes with putting your own logos or pictures on them. Depending on where you put the picture and what have you, can construct it in a way that you can actually brand the QR code, which a lot of companies are actually doing today as well. Let's create some QR codes in FileMaker. I have a FileMaker 19 file here, but it'll work with newer versions of FileMaker as well. And I'm using the API called QR Code Generator. That's where all the magic happens. I've created this demo file here, and I simply start with a base URL and then give it the text to encode. Then I can generate a QR code. Now, I did create this file in no time, and part of that was because I have quite a bit of experience now using APIs, and I learned all of that actually from our own course at Productive Computing University. And the name of that course is called API Fundamentals for FileMaker Developers. In that particular course, not only do we learn all about APIs, we learn specifically how to work with the FileMaker Data API, which in my opinion is one of the most important APIs you can work with, because if you're a FileMaker developer and you know how to talk to the FileMaker Data API, then that is a lethal combination of skills that you can really take to the bank. All right, so let's keep going here. So there's other parameters and options that the API gives you. You can go from size 10, which is a really small QR code, all the way to size 1000, which won't even fit in our container field here. And I'll just go back to 250. The default size is 200, by the way. I can also choose colors, and it accepts both the RGB type style as well as the web type style. So if I want to make my color green, I can do that, or blue, I can do that, and that'll color the lines. And it'll also color the background. If I want to color the background blue and then I want to make the actual lines red, I can do that too. Now, this color list comes from something I just whipped up in no time. I just put in four basic colors here, taken right from their API documentation. But you can put in any number of colors that you want if you wanted to give a user the choice to make the colors that are acceptable to them. All right, so let's go back to a default color, which I'll just blank these out here and generate a new code that way. Now I can also make margin adjustments. So actually I should have left the color there. Let me make a background green and make the margin 20. This will give us a 20-point margin all around, just like this. A little breathing room here, a little margin. And then this quiet zone dictates the size of the margin, so it kind of like doubles everything. So in other words, it'd be 20 is the margin, but I want to make the margin width 2. So 2 times 20 is 40, and that's what I end up with all around. So I'll put that back down to 0 here and then generate that. So there's some nice options. There's a few more options that are available on the API as well that you can do. You can dictate the amount of fault tolerance and some of the things like that. So I'll make this file available to you for free in the course called FileMaker Features and Free Resources. It's available at Productive Computing University, and I encourage you to check that out. It doesn't cost any money. You can download it and use it for your own development. So thanks for joining us on this video. Feel free to subscribe to the channel. If you like content like this, feel free to give it a like up. And don't be shy, leave a comment if you'd like, and to either provide feedback or ask more questions. We are definitely happy to answer those here on our channel. Thanks for joining us, and we'll catch you on the next one.